Hi, this is Laura Jackson from Discovering Dyscalculia. Today I want to talk about how to look deeper at issues that a child may be having in class. I'm specifically talking about dyscalculia, so that's a math learning disability. And oftentimes parents and teachers will see a student struggling in a particular area of math, and they don't look deeper to see why the student might be struggling. So for example, the student may be struggling with fractions. And so they come up with the books and the programs and the ways that they've been teaching fractions and try to continue that method with the student. The problem is, if you look a little bit deeper, you'll probably find that the learner hasn't grasped another concept that is a building block to fractions. So this happened to our family. My daughter was in sixth grade and they were working on fractions, and I bought a dyscalculia book on fractions by Ronit Bird. It was her ebook. And as I looked at the beginning of the book, it said, student needs to have grasped a foundational sense of division and multiplication. And I thought, that's not my kid. So I looked back at a previous book on multiplication and division, and same thing. In order to understand multiplication and division, there are some concepts that students need to understand before they can get there. Some of those concepts that my daughter did not even know, and which kept her from really understanding multiplication and division, which also kept her from understanding fractions. So you can see how we're going all the way back here. But some of those concepts were, she didn't yet know how to double, take a number and make more of it. She didn't know how to halve, take a number and equally divide it into two halves. She did not know all of her components of numbers, so she didn't know all the ways to build a number, or that numbers were inside of other numbers or made of other numbers, however that language is that connects. She didn't know how to bridge. Bridging is a technique dyscalculics can use to subtract and add. And she didn't know how to do that either. She didn't know how to, some people call it compose and decompose a number, or partition a number, recombine a number. So breaking that up or building it up. And then she also didn't really understand place value. So these are all kinds of concepts that are building blocks for multiplication and division, which are building blocks for fractions. And so in order to help her with fractions, we needed to go all the way back to some of these previous concepts and help her grasp those. I'll talk some more in some other videos about some other concepts and impacts on dyscalculia, and how we need to go all the way back to find out what is that core issue that's impacting their understanding of the concept we want them to learn. It can really help us out, because we can just be spinning our wheels and wasting time and really causing a lot of stress and frustration for our students when we don't understand what those core issues are that are impacting their understanding. Thanks for watching. This is Laura Jackson at discoveringdyscalculia.com.